Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. It's Masha. In this video we'll discuss 13 major hair trends for spring summer 2020. So if you're ready for that fresh nice haircut, then don't forget to subscribe and stay with me until the end of the video. And I put everything together in my notes, so if you guys don't mind, I'll be looking at them. So just to remember and not forget to mention anything for you. So we'll start from the haircuts, and then we'll be moving to the hair colors. Then we'll move to the styling, and then we'll move to the accessory section. Each of those sections, I will name three top, or maybe four in some of them, if I really like it. And you guys let me know which one was your favorite. And the first one that I'd like to start with will be the major hair trend for everything for this season, for spring summer 2020, will be 70s. 70s inspiration will be everywhere. We're already huge from the clothing collections, and now it's moving to the hairstyles. And the first hairstyle that will be so popular and will be so trendy according to the experts is called modern shag. And the iconic hairstyle from Farrah Fawcett will be on top right now and will be your reference if you want to get this modern shag look and to get the feathers all around. And this look requires the shorter layers around the face and what's flat on top, so which means that no volume on top and was flat and lots of volume right here. It's just like going on all these curls and beautiful curly stuff. I'm showing you pictures right here. And if you are ready for that dramatic change, then go for this haircut. It will be on top. It will be something new and something super trendy. I'm really excited for this haircut because it layers, in my point of view, it always looks very airy. You can play with it. You can just turn it this way. You can turn it straight, and it will add some texture to your hair too, because you have some layers and all around the face. The beautiful thing about modern shag is that it's effortless and you can just wash and go like that because you have layers and the texture is on top. Wash it, low maintenance, go, and don't even blow dry. And the second hair trend is bob. You can never go wrong with bob because it's always on trend, and for this season, spring summer 2020, it will be classic bob and asymmetric bob, which means that you can still have those sleek bobs, but now they're turning into more messy and shaggy kind of way, so there will be more volume and you can just wear it like a messy kind of hair. And the asymmetric ones, they go like the one side is longer and another one is shorter like this. They are on trend too right now. So if you're looking for some way to change your bob, or maybe just like bored of this bob, then go for asymmetric one, and maybe for some shaggy, just add in some texture, some volume to it, and it will be looking so great. And one more interesting way to play with the texture and to play with your bob or even like different kind of hair, if you get bored but you're not ready for these dramatic changes, then cut your bang. Adding bangs to bob haircut, I think it gives those cool vintage vibes, especially those curtain bangs that look amazing. And if you add those messy kind of hair, then they look so 70s. And also if you have long hair and you just want to add a little bit of change, then bang is a good idea too, because now it seems to be on trend. Most popular one right now is feathered bang, and also the curtain one, which is going sides like those ways. Beautiful thing about that, it's low maintenance and you can just wash your hair and go like that, because it looks better when it's messy. Gets this 70s vibe, because all girls in 70s, they had that curtain bangs or feathered bangs, and it was pretty long, and especially they used to wear it with a bob, which is going like this, and it's not the straight bob, but a little bit messy, a little bit crazy, a little bit wild, because they play so well together with the curtain bang and those messy hair. I think they look amazing. So if you got bored of your bob those slick bob, or you just want to play with the hair, just add some bang. So now we're moving to the styling section. If you are not ready for the haircuts yet, but maybe want to change a little bit of your style, then styling tips will be helpful. And the hair trend number 4 will be slick, polished hair. They also call it like a wet look, but for me it looks like this. It looks like you put all your gel on top of your hair and you just like brush it like this, or maybe your hair are super greasy and then you also brush it all the way to the ponytail by adding the gel, which is a good idea to hide your greasy hair too. And the clean and polished hairstyle was the overall at Carolina Herrera runway shows for spring 2020. So I'll show you some pictures right here with the models wearing their bobs, lobs, and even back length hair slicked back of the roots down to the neck. The quick tip how you can achieve this wet, slick look: you can grab your gel, then put it on your hand, then rub it, then take your hands and then move them slowly from your roots down, pulling back from the ears right here too, just like that. And all your hair will be all the way down, and this is the modern look. Hope you enjoy. The hairstylist of GHD ambassador Zoe Earing. The trick to achieving this style, according to Earing, is to use a hair mask instead of conditioner when washing your hair to add more hydration, and before using the product such as this on wet hair to guarantee a high shine finish. Yeah, if I use a mask instead of my conditioner, then I don't need any gels, I swear to God, because it's just like they will be super greasy and they will be super messy at the same time. But I'll try. And the hair trend number 5 is textured braids. This trend is not for everybody because not everyone wants to have those braids, and not everyone wants to, or it doesn't look good on everybody because it's just like so unique for every shape of head. For every person, it depends. Hair experts, they are saying that we'll see lots of hair braids this season, spring, summer 2020, from those small, like, you know, those beautiful long ones, to those those that you can make at home, those messy hair braids for the boho style, where you can just wear some long dress with it, or even the hat over it too. And adding some texture is very important for these hair braids, so they look voluminous, they look interesting, they look not flat but very voluminous and interesting too. Wild big curls are our next hair trend of this 2020 hairstyles, and I'm so excited for this one because it's just so interesting and so interesting, because from my hair they're very straight from the natural, and I don't even use any iron or the hair straighten because they're naturally straight. But I'm so curious to see how my hair looks with the curls. I think this trend is pretty amazing because all these curls, they are pretty popular right now, whether you have your own naturally curly hair or maybe you go with the curler, or even perms, they are so on trend now, and I'm really excited for this trend. This is the trend I think number one that I'd like to try this spring summer 2020. Let me know if you like it too and we'll try it together. And now we're moving to the coloring section, which is pretty exciting too. And hair experts are saying that for this spring summer 2020, you want to go for, if you are considering a change in your hair color, then you want to go to the warmer shades such as blonde. It will be like honey blonde, or in brunettes it will be those warmer shades. And the hair trend number 7 from the coloring section is bold bright shades, almost neon colors. Can you believe in that? Those neon colors were on trend for already a couple seasons, and now they're moving towards your head also. So everything, see that thing, everything from the clothing, it's moving to the hair too. So speaking about hair, that The Pantone color of 2020 is navy blue, I think, as far as I remember right. And the blue shades on the hair will be so trendy, especially those curly hair that looks so good with the blue on it. And all shades of blue will look amazing on every single person, whether you blonde or brunette, because you can play with the color. For blondes, it will be more pastel colors, I think, and for brunettes will be more vivid colors, bright and juicy, interesting. But you know what, I think for brunettes it looks amazing and it works beautifully. But for blondes, be careful with blue colors because it stains. It turns your hair green. I've tried it before. I've tried Colorista blue color, and because I love that blue color, I wanted to achieve this, like, you know, almost a light bluish color, but after washes and washes, my hair turned green. Not completely green, like, you know, like forest green or like this leaf, but they were like the green undertone, which is like so awful. Blonde hair with green undertone, it doesn't look good. It just looks so dirty, not clean, brassy. So it was not good. But it's a very good idea to play with a color, and you can play with a color with a semi-permanent colors, but those colors there washes out after washes and washes, and you left out with no color after it. But some hair color with blondes, they might have this, might give this like green undertone to your hair too, so be careful with that. You can try some on from the back and see how it reacts. So blue is on top, but also one more hair color which will be on top is hot pink. So remember how trendy was those soft pink, like a cotton candy shades of your hair? Now it's moving towards those bright shades, which is the crazy screaming that you're crazy and a wild person, because to have that hot pink is pretty crazy, but it looks amazing. I think it looks amazing on blondes, it looks amazing on brunettes too, but for brunettes it's a little bit more difficult to achieve because it's different pigment and it's darker. For blonde, it's really easy to achieve. You can even achieve it with this Colorista L'Oreal Paris in a soft pink shade or in a pink shade. I have a video how I dye my hair. I'll link it below too if you guys are curious. But this will be a trend for this spring summer 2020, which I'm so excited to. And I've seen some pictures where a girl had those pink hair and she braided from one side and then left some hair around the face, and was so gentle and so like feminine looking. And the hair trend number 8 is warm hair colors, meaning that those icy gray hair, remember how they were popular a couple years ago or even last year, those icy cold beautiful, my personal favorites, now they are seems to be not that trendy, but more of a like sun-kissed for summer. I think it's reasonable. I'm saying that because when it's summer, you don't want to apply too much color, you don't want to bleach your hair too much because it's summer, it's so hot, it's a lot of temperature. You go to the beach, you play with sand, salt, salty water, and then everything is just damaging your hair, especially when they are bleached, they start looking unhealthy. And I put some interesting shades which will be on trend from warm hair colors. The name will be Sandstorm. It's a mid-tone blonde, which is great for low maintenance blonde or brunettes who want some lightens. The key here is adding brightness around the face to give the illusion of lighter hair without the upkeep. Interesting. And the second one is a chocolate brown. With a chocolate brown shade, you can upgrade your brunette hair color and by adding a little bit more dimension in the chocolate shade to your hair color, which is amazing for summer and spring. And now we are moving to the trend number 9, solid hair color, meaning that you apply the same hair color all together on your hair from roots until the ends. I think the benefits of it just takes less time when you go to the salon, or you can do it at home too, just buying any shade. For example, if it's not blonde and you don't want to achieve any special, those expensive kind of shades, then you can do it at home using your own developer, mixing with the color that you'd like to, and just apply carefully, separating your hair from the roots until the end and achieving that solid hair color. I personally don't like the solid hair color because usually when your hair grows, they will leave those bold, bright, streaked lines with your natural hair color will be on the roots, and then it will be your hair color. So I don't like that, and it's not low maintenance in the end because you have to retouch it always and every 2 weeks. So that's why I prefer going from the natural, slowly moving towards the color. The onyx black and pale blonde colors were seen at Prada, and deep black and red at Miu Miu shows. And according to Casey Massimo, women are leaving highlights in 2019, opting instead for single process colors. Don't forget, from any of these things, the most important thing is that your hair looks shiny, sleek, and healthy. If your hair doesn't look that way, then any styling or nothing from hair color will help to this. So first of all, you'd like to achieve this healthy look, and then you want to experiment with the hair, because unhealthy hair doesn't look good no matter what. And now we are moving to the accessories, which is the safest place to play with your hair without changing anything. If you are not ready for the change, then you can play with accessories, which is so exciting too. And our trend number 10 will be pearls. Pearls were on trend, I think, for a couple seasons already, for that fall, winter 2019, and also in the summer 2019, as far as I remember. Remember those clips and everything? I think everybody already got bored of it, but now they're also moving to the one single pearl. So you can use like the single pearls all around your head, and it looks gorgeous. That one looks gorgeous. I personally don't like those hair clips, but those hair pearls, they looking amazing. One of the most stunning ways to wear pearls were seen on one of those runways where they were pinned into braids, the fishtail braids, and the bases of ballerina's buns. For the Rodarte lookbook, pinned pearls dotted through the hair lent a very romantic touch to glamorous retro hairstyle. Yeah, so pearls are on trend now, and I'm really excited to try out this trend, especially to play with those single pearls or in creating some very interesting shape of the pearls laying from your hair. So this one is yes for me. And the hair trend number 11 from accessories is headbands in all shapes and sizes. Now you guys probably already seen those huge headbands, the voluminous ones, the thick ones with pearls on top or with ring stones on top, and some of them even on the runway, the models were wearing the headband matching their hair color, which is absolutely amazing. I think it looks great, and it adds a little volume to your hair. It's not flat right here, but it adds a little bit volume, and it looks interesting. I think you can even match it with your earrings or some necklace too, and it will look amazing. So I'm really excited for this trend too, because it's interesting. It's really worth trying, especially for summer. Oh, and also they had some feathered headbands too, which is pretty interesting. I would opt for pearls, I think, and some ring stones maybe, and for solid hair color. But for feathered one, I think it looks more of a romantic and some special. But if you'd like to be youthful and playful and girlish this spring summer 2020, then our next trend is for you. The next trend, number 13, is hair bow and hair scarves. I think this is the simplest and the easiest way to play with your hair using the bow. It's so feminine, and if you're not ready for the color, then there are beautiful black bows which you can tie all around, like right here for the low ponytail, and leave some hair around your face, or you can put some bow on even your without any pony, just like this, and it will look amazing too. It will look stylish and interesting. And for the hair scarves, you can use it by braiding a hair scarf. You can do a fishtail braid or even the regular braid using the scarf. It looks amazing with some jeans for more of a 70s look again, or even will look great with some shorts, white shirt, blue jeans. All right, you guys, let me know in the comments below, what was your favorite hair trend for this spring summer 2020? Are you planning changes, anything with your hair? Personally, myself, I don't think so that I'm gonna change something critical, maybe something, I'm not sure, but let me know in the comments below what you're gonna try this season. And I love you guys so much. I'll see you in my next videos. Bye.